If you're interested in seeing how I created this short classic look using dip powder, then keep watching. If you're new to my channel, my name is Tia, and I'm the owner of Nail Dip Studio, an online nail boutique that specializes in dip products. So in today's video, I wanted to start off with showing you the station setup. I normally don't show, you know, sort of how I set up my station before I start my dip application, but I wanted to take the time to show you how I do, you know, my setup. Nothing too fancy, just having some quick essentials will help speed up your dip application. So right here, I have a dish towel, and some of these supplies I get from Dollar Tree, some I actually get from my product line, some I get from either like a Target or a Walmart, or even Marshall's or TJ Maxx. And then sometimes I also will go to the beauty supply store. But right here, I'm just using a dish towel. It's padded, and I like to have that extra padding because it actually acts as an additional layer if in the event that I spill some liquids. But I notice here I will have my nail file, I'll have my buffer. I usually use two different cuticle pushers because I like one has a pointed end and one has more of an angled end. And I use the pointer end to clean the free edge, and I like to use the angled end to actually assist in pushing back my cuticles and just, you know, helping me to like remove any product. I also will grab my cuticle nippers. And here's a pro tip for you. If your nippers did not come with a cover, like I usually they'll have like a blade cover that helps keep the blades sharp so that you don't start to have dullness. If it doesn't come with that, I'll show you in another video how you can kind of make your own little cover real quick to actually keep your blades and your point sharp. So right here, I'm gonna grab some paper towels. And again, I went to the Dollar Tree, they had some paper towels, I needed some. But they weren't the pre-sectioned paper towels. I usually like to have the ones that are pre-cut that you can sort of select your own size. But if you don't have that, don't worry about it. Just tear those bad boys in half. And I like to use the sort of half sheets because you'll notice when you're doing your nails, you may not need the whole paper towel. So, you know, just conserving a little bit. As I move forward, I will grab my cuticle softener. I also will grab a nail clipper. I also make sure that I have my dip powder brush, my dust brush right there. And I will also make sure that I have my clear powder at the ready, because I use that in two phases. I use it to help to bridge, to build the apex. And then I also use it to encapsulate the shades or the color so that the pigment doesn't rub off when you're fouling. Sometimes if you don't dip your nails in a clear to really sort of coat it, when you go to foul or buff your nails, you may notice that some of the pigment rubs off, and it's rubbing off because there's no protective barrier there. I also grab these little small glass dishes from the Dollar Tree. They come in like four to a pack, but I like that in terms of dusting off the powder that I'm not putting back into the container. I like to have it there and I just discard it. I will also have some cotton rounds as well as some lint-free wipes. I like using those just to help in aiding in my application of my nails to make sure that I don't have any lint from the cotton. So let's move on into the dry manicure. One of the things that I like to do, especially when I'm doing my dip nails, is doing a dry manicure. I find that it really does aid in your prep to have longevity with your application. So if you are experiencing lifting, especially around the cuticle and or side wall areas. Nine times out of 10, it's either because A, you didn't properly prep your nails, so you still may have some leftover product, some oils, cuticle tissue around the cuticle area and the side walls. You may also just have excess skin there as well, and that's not allowing the product to properly adhere to the nail plate. And if the product doesn't adhere to the nail plate, it will form a temporary bond, but not good enough to actually maintain the application. And so you'll start to experience lifting. And so I'm showing you here just how I sort of go in and just, you know, start to actually make sure that I am filing away any unwanted skin, hangnails, and I'm cleaning up that cuticle area. And I'm not too aggressive, so I'm not over filing. I'm using my e-file on, usually when I'm doing my cuticle area, I usually set it somewhere around 2, no more than 3. Because I don't want to be too rough with that area, especially if you're starting out and you really don't know the actual apparatus. If you're not really familiar with it, you want to start on a lower setting and then work your way up to a higher setting as you get more comfortable with the e-file. But it's definitely beneficial, but start out low. It's not a race. It's a marathon. You don't have to, you know, complete it, you know, hella quick. And you don't want to injure yourself. So just always try to start out on a low setting. Also, when you're using and you're getting an e-file, make sure that you have multiple bits. And you want to make sure that your nail bits, that you have a variety, because what may work for your hand and your comfort level may be something totally different. You may use a bit that I might not use, but you like the way it actually performs on your hand based on your skin, thickness of your skin, the type of work that you do, so on and so forth. So just be mindful about that when you're shopping around for an e-file. Next, I would say the other important thing in terms of maintaining longevity with your dip application is the shaping. Pre-shaping and doing your dry manicure, that is the key. That is how you take your dip application from being an amateur home application to a professional salon look. It is shaping your nail, I would say at least 80% of the way of what you want your final nail look to look like. Let me say that again. You want to shape your nail. You want to pre-shape your nail to about 80%, right, of what you want your final look to be. So if you're going for me, I had to cut my nails. I'm going for a shorter look. And I like to have a short tapered square nail with the, I don't do the rounded points per se unless I crack a tip or something. But if I am just doing my nails my normal way, it's gonna always be straight across, no curved tips, angled, tapered, with the dip overlay, okay? And right here, I'm just showing you basically what that final sort of look will look like. You know, it's not necessarily my perfect final look, but what this does is it allows more of the product to stay on my nail because I've already pre-filed my nails. And so I have the desired shape that I want already. So now when I go to do the dip application, I'm not going to have too much product buildup. Also, because I cleaned up the cuticle and the side walls, got rid of any hangnails, I know that as long as I am keeping my my dip brush, meaning my step to the base coat, as long as I'm keeping that near the cuticle area without flooding the cuticle or the side walls, that's going to provide me with a nice application and I will avoid lifting. I don't get lifting on my nails at all. So next, let's go into the wipe down. This is important. I usually will take, again, going back, grabbing one of those paper towels we took, we tore in half, and some alcohol. I will saturate that paper towel and start to wipe my nails off. This does two things. It removes the dust from the fingernail file and the e-file and gets off any debris, but it also starts the dehydration process, because what you want to do is you want to make sure that you're dehydrating your nail. You want to remove any oil, any leftover product that you may have had, lotions or anything of that nature, off of your nails. I then follow up with the lint free square, and I will spray that with alcohol, and I'll do a really good wipe down of my nails all over again, just to ensure that I don't have any residue pieces from the paper towel on my nail, because that's going to get, one, it's going to get on my primer, and two, it's also going to get on your base coat, and you're going to really have like lumps and bumps and things of that nature. So I try to do a once over just to make sure everything is really, really cleansed and cleaned. And then I look for any loose fibers or any type of cotton hairs that you may see on my nails, and I will remove those just to make sure I don't have anything on the nails. I'm next going to start with my primer. Primer is going to be step number one. Step number one is important because, again, this is going to dehydrate your nails, but it acts as a bonding agent for the base coat and the dip powder. And so it's going to actually help to adhere it to your nail plate. Okay, so that's something that you really do want to make sure that you do. Oh, and right here I'm showing, as I take one of those lint-free squares with a little bit of acetone, you always want to make sure that you're wiping off your bottle tips. That's another little tip. Before each application, and I would say after each application. If you do that, I didn't do it after my last application, which is why I have to do it now, but don't judge, okay? Thank you. But this is one of those things that you can actually do to help prolong your products, but then also too, to make sure that you don't have any clumps, any lumps and stuff like that, because that can affect the way that the product goes on, and you don't want to mess that up. So just take a little bit of acetone and a lint-free little square and just wipe around that little rim if you want. Okay, so what I'm showing you right now is when you're pulling, we're moving into step two, by the way. I don't know if I said that, but we're now in step two. Step two is the base coat. And that's the coat that you're going to use to actually apply and start to build your apex, especially if you like a little curvature. If you don't, if you already have natural curved nails or you prefer a flat nail look, then you can skip this step, meaning you don't have to create or start to build up your apex. What I would suggest that you do, however, is instead of doing a half of a strip to like really start that curvature, do a full strip from the base of your cuticle down and dip in. And you just want to add that protective barrier, because you are putting a pigmented, if you're using a color powder, you're using a pigmented powder, and it can sometimes stain depending on the color that you're using. It's no different than like if you've used red polish before and you take it off without putting a base coat on, and you might have a little staining from that. It's similar to that. So just put that little clear barrier down. Once you've started to do that and you've added your first layer, you want to dust everything off and just make sure that you're dusting it off and putting it into that little glass dish that I showed you earlier in the clip. So now what you're gonna do is you're gonna go in with a very thin layer, and you're going to go and apply your base coat. But what you don't want to do is you don't want to flood the cuticle and you don't want to flood your sidewalls. You want to make sure that you're bringing the product just shy of the cuticle area and avoiding the sidewalls, but sweeping the free edge. I like to leave my finger into the product for about, I would say, 6 seconds and then tap off. As you can see, I avoided the sidewalls and I didn't take it all the way back to the cuticle area. And again, that's because we're not trying to have product build up. We want to gradually build up our layers, but we don't want it so bulky back there in that cuticle space where we can't file. And we definitely don't want to flood the cuticle where you're actually now starting to have to file on your cuticle, which causes damage and it can be quite painful. So I wouldn't do that. So this is how I sort of do my nails. I slow and steady, but I do prefer just avoiding the cuticle area, at least in the beginning, because you're gonna put on, at least for me, I usually add about 4 layers, maybe 5, depending on, you know, what I have to do that week and how rough I'm gonna be with my hands. But because I know my products, and so I prefer to add a little bit more layers because I know that it gives me more longevity. So if you suffer from cracking or constantly chipping your nails or breaking the nails, it's probably because you don't have enough product. Your product is probably serving more like a gel polish and not like a builder gel, but like just a regular gel polish, and it's not strong enough. So you may wanna add additional layers. That's just a side note. So as we move into the second layer of the color powder, you're gonna see that I'm gonna start to bring the base coat closer and closer to the cuticle and the side walls. If you go over, try to catch that, use your finger, bring it over, take the excess off, dip your finger into your powder, let that sit for about 6 seconds or so, and then tap it off, and you will see, boom, there you go, right? You see how it's not flooding? Now there may be a little product right there on the side, but we can get that off, but it's a lot less than what would have been there because I did have a little overspill from when I was brushing my nails. So I'm gonna let you watch this and I'll be back. So now that we've completed the second layer, we're gonna move into the third layer. And I'm just gonna dust off, I like to dust off any extra powder that may be left over. And you always wanna make sure that you get underneath your nails as well. As I stated before, I typically like to have, you know, a few layers. And I'm showing you right now the thickness. Because, you know, sometimes I go back and forth with people in the comments about the amount of layers. And I find that it's preference, but my preference, especially because, you know, I'm active. I have a lot of things that I have to do in the course of the week and I use my hands a lot. And a lot of times, sometimes my depth can be a little off. I may hit my hand on a table, or if I'm at work, I'm constantly typing. So I need more layers, and I find that the more layers I have, it allows me to really still have some comfort from my dip application, as if I had the traditional, if you would, MMP monomer and powder overlay. So that's why I opt for additional layers. Again, very thin base coat application. Dip your finger into your powder at an angle. Do not try your hardest not to do, you know, all of the movement in the powder. And the reason for that is because you don't want to create ripples. You want to make sure that your hand, you try to keep your hand as steady as possible so the product can properly adhere. And I don't like to do a quick dip and pull out, because it doesn't allow the powder, especially if it's pigmented, to really adhere to the base coat. And you really want that base coat to grab and saturate the powder and the pigment so that you have a beautiful payoff at the end. So again, taking your time, always sweep your free edge, and especially when you have short nails, make sure your corners and your free edge, that is your currency, because your nails are already short, so you don't want to lose any real estate that you may have. So you want to take extra time and extra caution with applying enough base and allowing the powder to actually saturate and set on your nails properly. I'm going to dust everything off. And again, I like to make sure that I have that little dish there, because it helps with your cleanup process. It really, really does. I promise you that. So now we're going to move into my fourth layer, which is the clear dip powder. And this is a step that some people like to skip. But I would say that this is a very important step. It is extremely important, because this is what's going to keep your pigment from coming off, fouling off, and or rubbing off. And you want to make sure that you dip your nail in the clear powder. Now, what you saw right there is that I kind of went in three times, and I'll tell you why I did that. With the clear powder, because there is no pigment there. Sometimes that clear powder you need, it doesn't always adhere to the base coat in the first dip. So sometimes you have to go back and dip again just to ensure that it really catches on. So I'm going to go in, you see, I'm going to come out, I'm going to tap off, I'm going to go back in. Right, I'm gonna pull it back out, I'm gonna tap off, and I'm gonna go back in. And I'm doing this because I really want to make sure that that clear adheres to that base coat. And sometimes it doesn't, sometimes it doesn't. I purposely wanted my powder to be very fine, almost like powdered sugar, and I did that for a reason, because I find that it just gives you a better finish. It does. Trust my madness. It gives you a better finish. So now that we've done all of our fingers and we've dipped them into the clear and we've allowed that to set for a second, you then want to go in and apply step three, which would be your bond. And again, I put this on. I like to saturate it because I do a lot of layers. I will apply the bond twice. So I will go over my left hand, and then rotate, do the right, and then I'll come back to the left and I'll do it again. Now, I want to show you something really quickly. I fouled my right hand. I always foul my, I start with my less dominant hand, and then I rotate to the dominant hand to do the videos because it's easier for me to do that. But what I'm showing you here is I'm starting the fouling process. And as you can see, my nails are pretty much shaped, right? Because again, remember, you go back about 20 minutes, I had already started the shaping piece. So right now, I'm just now molding the powder into the shape that I want, but I don't have to over foul. And if you have issues with your nail from the free edge, separating from your overlay, 9 times out of 10, it's because you probably filed off too much. So we went through all of this trouble sweeping the free edge, which basically creates almost like a grip, like a clamp for the product. It's like clamping the product together with your nail. Well, if you file and you over file and you haven't pre-shaped your nails, well, guess what? In order for you to get your nails in that desired shape, and let's just say you're starting with like a semi oval shape and you want to get to a square shape, that's a lot of filing. You literally just filed off all of the layers that you just put on because you didn't do the pre-shaping. And one of the things that I like to do, especially when I am trying to get my nails, like that tapered look, is I like to take my nail file and I like to start at the top of my, like right where my cuticle and sidewall meet, and bring that straight down, as you can see, right? Because I'm removing that bulk. I don't do bulk at all. I didn't do it on my clients. I'm definitely not doing it on myself. So this is one of those tips and tricks that you can actually do, is start at the top, work your way down. If you're struggling with bulky nails, it's probably bulky because you're not hitting that sidewall at the top and you're really not following the natural direction. Now, if your nails they lack shape because, let's just say, you bit your nails or you bite your nails and you've never gotten your nails done, so you haven't really trained them in a sense, then I'll put a video up and explain to you how to do that. But if you are someone who your nails are you like the shape of your nails, you don't want to over direct your nails or train them to do something different, you're good with them, you just want to remove the bulk, this is how I remove the bulk. I make sure that I start on those side walls, I bring the file down. I'm using the 180 side of the nail file. If I have too much bulk, I will do the 100, but I go in single strokes. I won't go up, down. I go down and then I go to the other side and I go down and I rotate between sides. And the reason you want to do that is because the 100 grit is more abrasive. And when you have a more abrasive nail file, what tends to happen is people will overfile because they're using a more aggressive grit. I like to start out with the 180 because it's not as abrasive and it doesn't allow you to take off too much product in one swoop. It allows you to, you basically have to do a little bit more work to get that product down. But what I like about that, especially if you are someone who's just starting out or you're just getting, starting to get familiar with dip, this will allow you, if you have like the 180 side, this will allow you to really hone in on your skills and you'll be able to see the difference between the two. If it's a little bit more bulkier and you kind of want to like take off more, then I would say start with the 100 and then move to the 180. But if you're doing your pre-filing, pre-shaping, you can really do your nails with just the 180 side. And this is what your paper towel should look like. Like I literally just filed my nail and I'm just showing you how much fallout you should have from your buffing and your filing. If you have more than that, you took off too much product that's just not good, because literally you're probably going to have to do your nails in a couple of days because they're going to start lifting and you don't want that. That's the whole thing. So right here, I'm showing you this spot. This spot looks like it didn't properly set. And sometimes that happens. And I didn't want to edit this out of the video because some of you may have gone through this. So what I'm going to do is continue to file, continue to buff, to get my sort of desired shape. But guess what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna grab the bond, step number 3, and I'm gonna reapply that to that to that specific area. And the reason that I'm doing that is because I want to make sure that I set my nail. Okay, I want to make sure I set it. I want to make sure that everything cures and it gets hard. And as you can see, you can't tell, and you won't be able to tell even once I apply my top coat. So I'm going to do all of my nails, shape them, and then come back with the rinse and the wipe. Now, what I like to do is I always go and I wash my hands with a nice soap. And I have a brush at my sink. So I go in and I brush and I wipe and I brush. And I really want to make sure I'm getting off all of that extra powder off of my nails. I also like to let my hands dry for about 5 minutes. Now, that is what I recommend for people to do. I mean, you don't have to wait 5 minutes. You can really probably wait like 2 or 3. But I just like to sit and let my nails completely dry, because sometimes if you've ever experienced putting on your top coat and then you go back and you see that your top coat is somewhat shifting and changing and it's not acting right, or you see this white cast on it, 9 times out of 10 is because you still have water on your nails that had not completely evaporated, and now that water is trapped under that top coat and it's trying to escape. So instead of it evaporating into air, is now changing the composition of the top coat, and it's going to leave you with like a bumpy, lumpy surface. So I just like to let my nails dry completely for a few minutes before I add my top coat. I then go and I'll do the other hand. I'll come back and then I'll start the top coat again. And again, I go in thin layers. One layer and then the second layer. And then I completely let my nails dry without any fans on. I let them dry at room temperature, specifically for about, I would say, 10 minutes or so. I just sit, I'm watching Netflix or something like that, and I'll just let my nails dry, because the less you move, the better your result will be. Okay. And this is sort of like my final result. And this dip shade, I don't think I mentioned this. This shade is called Bait, and it's available on my website at naildipstudio.com. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.